In the early years of her career, there were those who told Maggie Gyllenhaal that she wasn't pretty enough or attractive enough for certain roles. I hope those fools kick themselves stupid every time they see one of her performances, because for almost 30 years now, she has been one of our most underrated, ambitious, independent, and not to go all male gazy on you all, but yes, attractive performers on both large and small screens. A graduate of Columbia University, Maggie started acting around the same time as her brother. You know. And while she hasn't completely avoided doing blockbusters, for example, The Dark Knight, she is known for performing in films with budgets that are perhaps lower than what it costs to make Venom's tongue move. Her first big role was in Secretary, Stephen Schamberg's 2002 romantic comedy, where she experiences an awakening in more ways than one when she develops a BDSM relationship with her employer. It was a role many told her not to take, perhaps viewing it as an unsafe choice. But Maggie took it anyway, because as the rest of her career has shown us, Maggie Gyllenhaal doesn't play it safe. She has delivered a number of strong performances through the years, as a secretary, a woman fresh out of prison, a member of the weirdest band in the world, a 19th century suffragist, and a 1970s streetwalker. All seem different, but have a few things in common. These women strive for independence. They do whatever they have to do, even things they're not proud of, to achieve their goals. There are women, like Maggie herself, who don't lie low and play it safe. And each performance is punctuated by that face. I could think of few performers who seem to have control over every muscle in between their forehead and their chin like Maggie does. Whether she's laughing, crying, especially when she's crying, Maggie's face, the same face people said wasn't good enough for roles starting out, is her greatest asset. She is one of the few who has successfully made the transition from film to television, first with The Honorable Woman, which earned her first Golden Globe, and HBO's The Deuce, where she plays Candy, a pimpless prostitute who makes the transition from prostitute to porn star to director. On top of being an actor and producer, Maggie is going into directing her first feature, an adaptation of Alain Ferrante's The Lost Daughter. Even though I'm excited to see what Maggie can do now, off camera, I still hope that we get more chances to see the honorable, ambitious, fiercely independent Maggie Gyllenhaal on screen for many years to come.